Now that we have seen flush, stall, and forwarding as a solution for hazards in a pipeline, let's do a quiz to see if you know when each should be used. Let us say that we have a 5-stage pipeline where the first stage fetches the instruction, the second stage decodes the instruction and reads the registers, the third stage, the instruction does the ALU operation, and a branch is resolved so we know where it's going. In the MEM stage, loads and stores access memory, so at the end of this stage, a load will finally have a value, and finally, the fifth stage writes the result to the register. Here we have some hazards. First, there is a control hazard. After the branch, we fetch two wrong instructions before we fetch the correct multiply instruction in this case. So the red ones are the ones that are fetched incorrectly. The question for you is, should be flush, stall, or forward here? Put a check mark in each of these three boxes, depending on which one we do here. Next, we have a data dependence where the multiply is producing the R1 result and the load needs to use that as the memory address. Put a check mark in each of these three boxes, depending on whether we need to flush, stall, or forward the value in this case. And finally, the load is producing the value of R1 that this add needs to use. So the question for you is, should be flush, stall, or forward in this case? Note that in some cases, more than one of these needs to be used for optimal performance. To help you get started, I'm gonna tell you that for data dependencies, as we said, we never want to use flushing. So the real question is just, should you stall or forward?